Well, my friends, we are at one of my favorite places on the planet, Circuit Mont-Tremblant in Quebec, to drive this thing, the all-new Civic Type R. As you know, I'm a fan of Honda's products, and I've been dying to drive this thing. I can't wait. So come along for a spin. Let's take this out onto the track.
First, a little bit of context. The Civic Type R is kind of a big deal, especially for us in North America. While this is the sixth Civic Type R in Honda history, it's the first Civic Type R that's been made available to us. While Honda's been making headlines with a crazy 7-minute, 43-second Nürburgring record lap time for a front-wheel drive car, that's only really just one aspect of this new Type R. Sure, the numbers are meaningful. It's got a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine that makes 306 horsepower at 6,500 RPM and 295 pounds of torque, a wall of torque from 2,500 to 4,500 RPM. It's actually a pretty special motor, and perhaps we'll get into more detail when we have the Type R in for local testing. There's a more rigid chassis too. It's slightly better than the current base hatch and massively better than the old Type R. It also has stronger control arms, trailing arms, steering column, rod ends, all to cope with the greater loads this Type R is capable of generating. On the outside, there's a ton of functional aero, from increased cooling to brake ducts to the boy racer, functional rear wing. And don't quote me on this, but these may be the first original equipment vortex generators I've seen in North America.
Well, my friends, we're at one of my favorite circuits, as you know, Circuit Mont-Tremblant. And some of you may know, I've raced here and love this place. And it's absolutely a fantastic place to test this car. As you know, I'm a bit of a front-wheel drive junkie. And as much as I love big horsepower rear drive cars, I love a really well set up front-wheel drive car, and there is absolutely no question in my mind this thing is brilliant. It's as neutral as you're gonna get for a front-wheel drive car, and I'm gonna put it in back in R plus mode. This car is really, really remarkable in a lot of ways. The brake pedal, I'm a big fan of. Lots of confidence. Very, very precise with modulation of that pedal. You can really position the car on the brake pedal. But what is exceptional is the way the car behaves under traction and stability control intervention. Now, we're in R plus, or plus R mode, and I really can't feel the system's work. Even in sport mode, where I saw the traction control light flashing, it's really indiscernible except for that flashing light. Doesn't hold you up, doesn't interfere with what you're doing, and makes this Civic Type R a remarkable track car. Now, we're kind of doing speeds where all of the Type R's aero should be active, and I'll tell you, corner 1, 2, and 3 here at Tremblant is fast, it's crazy, and this Type R is exceptionally well balanced. If you're wondering why I've got this ballast here, his name is Brody, he's really not talking, he's another one of us, he's a racer, but this is the Honda Canada launch event for this vehicle, and I am mandated to have this ballast here. He says he's having a good time. If he looks nervous at all, well, tough luck. We're having fun with this Type R. But back to this car. Balance is exceptional. It's really a complete package. And yeah, we all know how fast this thing is around the Nürburgring, but that's not what this car is really about. It is absolutely the finest front-wheel drive car I have ever driven. It is just exceptional in every way. Steering is precise, brakes are awesome, as I mentioned. Power is mega, and of course, because 2-liter turbo makes so much torque across the rev range, it just accelerates all the time. It is so much fun, but you know, if you drive it well and precisely, and you know, aren't a bit of a jerk with the controls, this thing rewards you all day long, as I'm doing here. There's no complaints from the car. It is just doing exactly what I'm asking it to do. It's absolutely a blast. Great feel from the chassis too. You can really tell what the tires are doing. There is a, you know, bit of turbo lag between shifts, but that's to be expected. But that torque really makes up for it. It is just awesome. Now we're going through corner one at about just shy of 140 kilometers an hour in this Type R, and it just feels very, very stable. It's just I don't know. I'm lost for words. The car is so good. I'd love it to look, you know, a little less boy racer, but that's not up to me. But the way this car drives, it is, no question, the finest front-wheel drive car I have ever driven. The Brembo brakes, the Continental tires are all working exceptionally well. Honda's done a brilliant job with the chassis. It's quite good. The seats do their job here, and we're able to, you know, generate some pretty high G loads in the corners, and these seats for an OEM seat do a great job of keeping you in place. It's unquestionably a driver's car, no question in my mind. The other thing is, of course, the rev matching is switchable on and off, which is what I like, and there's no sort of default on mode, which is great, so you can leave it off and it stays off. And for a driver like me, I'm gonna leave that off and let my feet do the actual throttle blipping, which I guess is a bit old school these days, but it's to me, it's the way to go. And if you don't know how to heel and toe, this isn't a bad car to learn the technique as well. But wow, I am absolutely having a blast in this thing. Total confidence in that brake pedal can really place this car anywhere I like. That is the end of this session, my friends. So hopefully got a sense of what this thing is about on the racetrack, and we're looking forward to a more extensive test on the road with this Type R in the coming weeks. But here on the racetrack, it is absolutely brilliant. And of course, because I'm mechanically sympathetic, we're gonna let the brakes and the systems cool down now. So thanks for joining me on track. More in a bit.
To be fair, I can't comment on how the adaptive dampers work on the road, but on the track, they're excellent. The brakes are just brilliant on track as well, so you're not gonna need any more than these for the road. Honda execs touted the limited slip diff and the dual axis front suspension geometry as the solution to banning torque steer from this car. And I actually didn't believe them until I got out of the car. Yep, there's no perceptible torque steer on this racetrack. This is just a brilliant car. Of course, with a turbo motor, the sounds coming out of the exhaust are muted, to say the least. My only other real criticism is the boy racer styling, and I'm not sure I'd want to be caught driving this Type R, but on the other hand, this is what a Type R should look like, so I suppose if you buy one, you're going to have to own its garish looks. We're really looking forward to a longer real-world test with the Type R in the coming weeks, so stay tuned for that. I can't wait.
I hope you like this piece on the 2017 Honda Civic Type R. Hopefully I conveyed how awesome this car is. If you're looking for one, you need to buy one. It is brilliant. It's gonna make you a track day hero. If you can master this thing, it's gonna be faster than Corvettes, Porsches, all sorts of things at your local track day. So if you like this sort of thing, you need to buy one. This is hands down the fastest and easiest to drive front wheel drive car I've driven in a long, long time. Anyway, thanks for watching this piece about the Honda Civic Type R. Hope you did like it. And if you did, be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. And as always, we want to know what you think. And with this car, we're going to get a lot of opinions about this. So please let us know what you think. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.